Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. FL Studio 24 just keeps getting better, so I need you guys to smash that like button for more videos. I'm going to show you how to flip your melodies into chord progressions and mangle your melody using the new chord progression tool. Let's hop straight into it. So if you guys don't know, what we're going to use is this program called Lemonade to generate a melody. And what you didn't know probably is that the chord progression tool is more than chords. So let me show you guys how it works. First, we're going to generate a melody using Lemonade. Now, this is not with FL Studio. This is a separate program. Let's do melody. Let's do the key C minor. And you could select the mood. Let's do dark, even though C minor is kind of already dark. And then we're going to do get seeds. Okay, so here we have to sign up or link our BeatStars account. So I'm going to sign in real quick. Now that we're in Lemonade, I'm basically going to click on the mood called dark. I hit get seeds and now it labels it by key. So Travis Scott's known for the key of E minor and F minor. So we're going to hit on this one. Now that has the sound that I want. So we're gonna click in the bottom left where it says drag MIDI to DAW. We're just gonna left click and drag it into FL Studio. Now I have my plugin loaded up called Hercules. You can find this at busyworksbeats.com/Hercules. The patch is called Plux Dragon. So we're gonna go to Lemonade real quick. Left click the bottom left where it says drag to your DAW. Drag it straight inside of FL Studio. Hit accept. Okay, so now we have this MIDI. Now for my ear, I want just that part. The rest, we're gonna get rid of this. Let's clone this. Now the cool part about FL Studio's chord progression tool, you can build chords around your melody. So let's hit Control Up. I like to separate my melody at least up one octave. Hit Alt P or go to the tools here. Go to generate chord progression. Now it's gonna build chords around. I like everything except this G over D chord, so let's switch this to E minor. And now we have a chord structure around our melody that we just created. We can also hit Control A, and we can go to performance and switch this out for a different performance. Now this will override, it will kind of clash with our melody that we just created, but if you guys did want to add rhythm to your melody, you could try these performances. It's actually kind of hard. Let's go with this one, even though it's a lot going on. So again, what I didn't know the chord progression tool could do more than chords, and I didn't know it could build chords around what we feed it. So it knows the key now, which is E minor. And now I can go back to Hercules and swap out the sound. So let's say I want more of a bell sound for some reason. Let's do dark side. Now, I already processed the sounds, but you guys can run more processing. So I made all the sounds in Hercules at busyworksbeats.com/Hercules. But let's say you want to mess with it. Let's go to kilohertz, which is a free plugin. We're going to go to the pitch shifter. Pull this down 3. It's like one of my favorite things to do. Now, we're in a different key at this point. Here's a trick. If that's too fast for you, right click the tempo, go to half speed. Let's swap out the sounds. Let's try some different sounds. Also in Hercules, you can mark your favorites. So I like that for this Travis Scott style. Let's try. I'm gonna mess with the release too. This is filled right here. Nah, this is it right here. This is the loop. Now I want to add bass. I didn't want to make this video super long, but now my brain has to add bass. Let's go to Hercules because it also has really good bass in here. My favorite kind of starter bass is called SO. It just hits, it comes out the speaker. It's hard to hear the bass though. There we go. I need that, but down an octave. All right, so I'm going to record 2 notes. Thank you. going to the dark side of the moon, boys. I need you guys to smash the like button, subscribe if you're new, grab Hercules at busyworksbeats.com/Hercules, and grab Lemonade, because you just saw how we flipped this. Also, grab FL Studio 24 if you haven't already. For a limited time, too, I keep forgetting to tell you guys, but for a limited time, use the code all caps. It has to be all capital letters, early bird, one word, all caps, early bird. I'll spell it in FL Studio so you guys can see it, but that will give you a discount, but it's only for limited 4th of July time. After 4th of July week, it's not going to be applicable. So if you're watching this in the future, it's not going to work. So here's how you spell it. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/Hercules and type in this code at the discount code at the very end of your checkout. All caps, early bird. It will take off 50%. I'd recommend the everything bundle because you get access to 60 plus music production courses on music theory, mixing, sound design, genre, beat making, drum patterns, all that. And you get 60 plus music production courses on top of the Hercules plugin, on top of what's called our Sounds Vault, which is like all our sound packs combined. So you get everything I offer basically for like $50 right now with this discount, which is insane because I charge $50 a month for my premium training alone. So it should show you the equivalent here. It's a $5,000 value on the premium stuff. So anyhow, use that code. It's only for a limited time. If you're watching this in the future, it won't count. It's not open. It's only for the people who invested early. Let's drop the bass down an octave. I want to see how low it can go. Try Bloody Bells. That has a dope name to it. I went ham on these bells. When I was making the bells, I was in a zone. There's 340 plus sounds in Hercules, by the way. Bells, brass, keys, leads, pads, plucks, bass. My favorite genres, though, are the bass and the plucks. Along with the bells, that's when I went in. I could sit here all day and go through patches. This would be like a breakdown part. Yo, I could get intoxicated with my sounds all day long. I want you guys to have some fun, but that's the new FL Studio 24 chord progression tool. Let me show you one more thing before we wrap. What you can do is actually build it from scratch. So if you hit Alt P or just hit that tool icon that I showed you before, I don't know how to start from scratch. Reset. Okay, let's see what this does. Okay, let's restart it from scratch. So right now, just pick random chords. What we're going to do is right click. We're going to go to Edit. And let's try a minor scale. We're gonna do, let's say, C minor. So I'm right clicking on these options here. Let's generate it again. And you could also select which octave you want these chords. So it's, if it's five, it's a normal octave. If it's four, it's a lower octave. The higher the number, the higher the octave, the pitch, I meant. Now what we can do is click the random tool to create random seeds for these chords. So I'm gonna hit random on the rhythm. The only thing about random is it is that which is random. So it can miss dramatically or it could hit dramatically. So what I'm going to do is hit random a couple times, but we're not going to sit here all day long until we get something good. I wouldn't normally use random, but this is in the case that you guys want to start from a random place. It's almost like in Minecraft how you have seeds and you can start with like a random seed. Same thing. Like this is kind of hard. This is actually kind of hard. Now that, I'll accept that one. Now what I want to do from here, let's hit Alt P. I'll show you guys a couple more things you could do. You could right click any chord. You could change the voicing of the chord to different styles. You can do, you could add extra notes. You could change out the bass. You could transpose the entire chord. You can invert the chord. What else can you do from here? We can even force a chord in here. So that's if you guys are really knowing what you're doing. You could add a passing chord. So like on the second chord, let's say you wanted a small change up, you could right click and add a passing chord. And it changes up the vibe a little bit to pull you away and then pull you back in. That's a nice way to add like change ups, passing chords. And what else can you do? So, and then you can go again to the performance tab, hit Control A. We're gonna swap out this performance. This is whoever made Up 3, shout out to you. Whoever made that preset right there, Up 3 is the one. So there's a lot of different presets, but they're all different like vibes. To me, the arpeggios work the best, but you guys could do whatever you want. I'm literally going to close my eyes and pick a preset, and let's see what this did. Right, let's do it again. Bell Tavern, here we go. The sound needs to be higher octave. Try a different one. That one's a little more atonal, but it's meant for tones as well. It's called What's Satinin. Wow, this one's loud. I also have a built-in filter, so this one's very sharp to the ear. It's not meant to be played like a chord, so you can muffle the sound there. That one's very specific of a sound, so we're gonna skip that one for now. I forgot we're going through keep the pitch shifter. Forgot about that. So again, I can sit here all day and listen to my sounds, but I want you guys to hear it for yourself. Just go to busyworksbeats.com/Hercules. It's my new plugin with 340 sounds. It's a VST plugin. It works for FL Studio, Ableton, Studio One, anything that supports VST. We're working on the AU version with Logic. I still have to test that on a new computer. VST plugin, 340 plus sounds. Go learn about it, busyworksbeats.com/Hercules. And again, shout out to FL Studio 24. These updates are starting to really, I'm starting to see how to use this stuff in context now. All right, guys, subscribe if you're new. Peace.